Hey, this is Darren with the Junk in My Trunk radio show. Check out Morris Trash Hauling. Hauling of all kinds, 7 days a week, 816-252-8270. You can also check him out online at morrishauling.com. Free estimates, 7 days a week, total home cleanouts from A to Z. Handyman work available, power washing and staining. Again, senior citizen discounts available, 20 years experience, 816-252-8270.
Painter's Choice. We also have a location down at Harrisonville on the square, which is Boutique 7. And then we are going to open our third location in Belton as well at Stacks Depot over on North Scott.
This painted furniture has been a real big craze in the last, it's really picked up momentum in those last 5 to 6 years. Do you know what the buzz is all about?
Well, I think as far as the newer generation, they don't have the appreciation for the old antiques, and what we're finding is people that can bring back life to an old piece of furniture that the finish has just seen its years, so the paint will bring new life to it.
It's pretty incredible, and I noticed that, you know, one man's trash, another man's treasure, but you can change it up so much.
Oh, without a doubt. And that's where, when I go to estate sales, I usually head for the basement, because that's where you can find someone's old piece of furniture was broken through the years, and all it needs is a little love, some glue and clamps, and some Amy Howard one-step paint, and you're ready to go with the new piece.
So now, Amy Howard, now that paint is something that you, what made you go with Amy Howard paint versus the other chalk paint lines out there?
Well, actually, I had made my own paint for 5 years, and then I came across a piece of laminate that would not, I couldn't get my paint to adhere to. So at that point, I went all through Kansas City and tried all that they had to offer. Mm-hmm. And Amy Howard was having a class down at Restoration Emporium. Mm-hmm. Well, little did I know that they were the actual distributor for Amy Howard. So after my friend Doris and I attended the class, we spoke to them about becoming a retail location, and it is just a great paint because it has low VOCs and it dries within 20 minutes. There's no sanding, stripping, any of that, or waxing. It's very easy to paint with.
That's pretty cool. And now, throughout the metro, now we're over here at Ruby Red Slippers. Tell us a little bit about Ruby Red, your location here, and then also your workshop back here.
Yes. Ruby Red Slippers is one of six antique stores here on historic Main Street. And I've been with Ann Knotts and Tom Knotts. I've been at this store for about 8 years. I started out with one booth, and now I currently have three booths in the store. It is actually, I think Tom and Ann been here about 10 or 12 years, I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. But what makes this special is that it has a good collection of the old antique pieces that haven't been restored, as well as some new painted furniture.
I think it's really nice. And you have classes back here. What days do you have your classes here?
Typically, we'll have them on a Tuesday night or Saturday or Sunday, and we do have private parties. So that way, matter of fact, I'm setting up for a party for a Sunday school class. So we do classes for bridesmaids classes, and it's just a fun time for ladies to get together, the Redhead Society, that sort of thing. So if they're interested in having a private class, or one of ours that is scheduled, will be on the Painted Branch Facebook page.
That's awesome. Now, I also notice that, you know, for young and old, obviously, we have your grandchildren here today as well, and they actually are into doing some of the picking with you and doing some painting as well.
Yes, Alex, he is my 12-year-old grandson, and his favorite thing to do is to go picking with Nana, and he's really going to become a good junker when he grows up, because he's already there building the muscles. And then my granddaughter Ashley, she actually helped, as well as Audrey, at their fall festival. This Amy Howard product has taken me to a new level, and unfortunately has slowed down my grandparent time, so therefore they have went on this journey with me, and so they're a blessing to have with Amy Howard paint, because they are my little helpers.
They really are. And I had a Nana too growing up, so we had Nana and Bob, but I know how it is to have a really good Nana. Why don't you kids come over here real quick. How you doing?
Good.
And what was your name?
Ashley.
Ashley, what do you like about painted furniture? Now you actually painted a piece too, as well.
Yes. What I like about the paint is that it's kind of fun to use, and it's a nice experience to have with my grandma.
And you actually sold it. You sold a piece, right?
Yes.
Right after you painted it?
Yes.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much. I appreciate you coming on. Now this is your grandson here.
Yes,
here, come on over here.
This is Alex.
What's your name, Alex?
Alex.
So you like going picking with Nana?
Yes, I do.
What kind of finds do you find out there?
Old furniture, broken or good.
Is that right? So what, you're attracted to furniture?
Yes.
So you know that Nana can make it, pop it, make it colorful?
Yes, I can.
That's awesome. We appreciate you coming on. We have another little one over here. Come on over here real quick. Might have to get you to stand up on the stool here. Can you stand up here? Can you stand up there? What's your name?
Audrey.
Audrey. So what do you like about painting furniture and stuff like that? You like painting furniture?
Yes.
Are you pretty good at art?
Kind of.
Kind of? You like it?
Yes.
Awesome. What grade are you in?
First.
That is very cool. What school you go to?
Peculiar Elementary.
Very good. We appreciate you coming on the road show today. You love your Nana?
Yes.
You mind your Nana?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much. I want to get you guys all in here real quick. And we have a little tagline on our radio show and our road show. It's a big Jed Clampett woo doggies. Can you give me woo doggies?
Woo doggies!
Awesome. Hey guys, you've been listening to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. Check out the Painted Branch at three locations. They're up here at Ruby Red Slippers, downtown Belton, Missouri, over at Boutique 7 over in Harrisonville, Missouri, and also coming up Stacks Depot here in Belton. And you've been listening to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. We'll be right back.
We're the kids from the Painted Branch, and we love Junk in Our Trunk radio show.
Woo, doggy!
Hey, this is Darren with the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. If you're looking for a used car, check out Fat Boy Motor Company. They've recently relocated to Blue Springs, Missouri. They're located at 23110 East US 40 Highway. You can reach them at 816-228-2222. And online at fatboymotorco.com. If you're looking for a used car, check out Fat Boy Motor Co. Woo doggies!
Hey, welcome back to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. We're over here at Family Tree Antiques and Collectibles. Scott, how you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you doing today?
Doing awesome. Thank you for taking the interview with us. Can you tell the listeners and the viewers a little bit about Family Tree?
Sure. Family Tree Furniture, we've been open for 5 months now. We're located in downtown, the old part of downtown Belt, Missouri, Old Main Street. The businesses have been here, or the buildings have been here since the late 1800s. It's about 6,000 square foot of antiques, collectibles, and furniture. We're turned into a great destination spot for all of Belton. There's five antique stores right here on the street. It's kind of a little hidden gem in South Kansas City.
I'll tell you what, it is really, really cool store. The vendors that you have here are top-notch collectors and pickers.
They are. I've been extremely blessed with great, great vendors. I've got 15 vendors, about 10 or 15 people I'm going to sign you for. They've all adapted kind of the Family Tree attitude as far as how we want the booths to look, and they do a great job, really a great job finding great things for people to come in and take a look and shop.
I know. Well, I find here you have a lot of this and that, but yeah, I see a lot of European style antiques here, where normally when you're out and about, you don't see a lot of European style antiques.
Well, what we try to do is just a good mix of everything from mid-modern to 18th century. We have everything, every type of piece of essentially any age of furniture you can imagine. collectibles, primitives, and then we also have a couple of our vendors do great job repurposing things. So painted furniture, it's just a really good mix of everything.
Definitely a great destination to come down, visit downtown Belton, and to experience your store, and some great places to shop and eat while you're down here, and make it a destination, a day trip. But I'd say it probably takes a good hour or so to go through your store to really see what you're looking for.
That's pretty much spot on. It takes a good hour. It's one of the great things about antiques, people go antiquing. And so between my store, Family Tree Furniture, there's Ruby Red Antiques across the street. We have Whistle Stop Antiques, Eleanor's, and Simply Charmed. It's three blocks of family-owned stores. So it's a great place. Right next door is an old 50s malt shop. If for any gentleman out there, there's a true man cave across the street. If he has one of it, he has three of them. great. If you're into hunting, there's a knife store, Knives and More. So just in general, it's a good afternoon to come spend, bring the family. In the back, there is a old locomotive that on the weekends they do train rides for the kids. So as far as, it's family friendly, any age, come down, spend an afternoon. It's a great time.
Now, what are your hours of operations over here?
We're open Monday through Friday, 9 to 6 and 8 to 5 on Saturdays. It's pretty friendly.
It is, and I'll tell you what, Family Tree is a great destination. Guys, you got to come down here and check it out. You won't believe the vendors' quality of antiques and collectibles. What I like about your store is, like, you're going to come in, you're going to find something you absolutely had to have and didn't know you had to have it.
Yeah, and one of the fun things, it's people come in, and one of the things I like the best, we'll have anywhere from people from, you know, your grandparents' age to kids. And they go through and they see things that they saw when they were kids, or they see their mom or their grandparents' things, and it's step into the past, which is great.
It definitely is. Now, how can they follow you on Facebook?
We're on Facebook under Family Tree Furniture. We have familytreefurniture.com, and we have Instagram and Instagram and Twitter site, all under Family Tree.
Very good. And what's the telephone number?
It's 816-500-5762. And also, we're getting ready to expand another 1,000 square foot. So if there's anybody out there looking and possibly interested in renting a booth, what we're doing, you get your first month for free. Come in, try it out, get your feet wet, see if you like it, and come join the store.
Very good. And so space could be anywhere from 10 by 10 or 10 by 20? Or
We go as far as 4 by 8 to up to 300-400 square feet.
Oh, my goodness.
So it is a good size. The other thing we do, maybe it's a little bit different, all my vendors have their own QR codes and their own apps for their spot.
That's right.
We send out 10,000 text messages, 10,000 emails every single month to promote the store. And we have an SMS, MMS texting platform that I show the vendors how to integrate their apps and their QR codes to help promote their own spot.
That's awesome. So you kind of have a store and a virtual store within the store.
Absolutely. So it's good. We do a lot of promoting to help the store, and also more to help the, make sure that the vendors are successful.
That's awesome. And again, exactly where are you located here in downtown Belton?
It's 401 Main Street, just right off Y Highway in Belton, Missouri.
Very good. Hey, now we have a tagline on our radio show and our road show. It's a big woo doggies. Can you give me woo doggies?
Woo doggies.
Perfect. Thank you, Scott.
You're welcome, buddy. I appreciate it.
Awesome. Hey, guys, you've been listening to the Junk in My Trunk Roadshow. Come down here and check out the family tree. You'll be glad you did. And you've been listening to the Junk in My Trunk Roadshow. We'll be right back. Thanks, Scott. Hey, this is Uncle Darren reporting live at Giggles and Jiggles Family Fun Center, located at 3713 US 40 Highway, 816-228-8179. If you're looking for that next birthday party, special event, walk-in and play, arcade, team parties, off-site rentals, you name it, open 7 days a week. Again, they're located at 3713 US 40 Highway, Giggles and Jiggles Family Fun Center. We're going to give them a big woo doggies.
This is Stan Kreider with Kreider's Institute of Welding Technology. We're located in Grain Valley, Missouri, just 10 minutes east of Kansas City. We are now offering once a month a hobby class for the hobbyist on Saturday. We will cover anything you need to weld with any process, stick, TIG, MIG, oxyfuel, or plasma cutting. Come and join us in the fun of making things. Our phone number is 816-352-6354. We're now taking applications for the fall semester. We offer a 20-week master welding course to prepare you for all kinds of industry settings. We will teach you steel, stainless steel, aluminum welding, and all the processes. Come and join us or just drop by and we will be happy to show you our state-of-the-art facility. Again, that number is 816-352-6354.
Hey, welcome back to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. We're over here at the Yarn Mercantile with Angelica. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Pretty close. Your name is it's long and it might be difficult, but I did say it right.
Yes, you did.
Now, can you tell the listeners and the viewers a little bit about the Yarn Mercantile? Now, you guys are located over here in Independence. Can you tell the listeners and the viewers a little bit about your store?
Yes, thank you, Darren, for coming by. Yes, we're in the Yarn Mercantile building, and there's two yarn stores in here, Knit Craft Yarn Shop that used to be located on the plaza, and Angelica's Yarn Store. The selection in the stores are two totally separate types of yarns and companies, so it's a huge, huge selection.
It's really, in knowledge, a huge selection. This is a huge place. How many square feet do you guys have over here?
There is 5,400 square feet in this warehouse.
It's amazing. Now, do you guys do classes and stuff like that?
We have open knitting tables. You can come by at any time and sit at our tables and knit. And if you need help with something, we will help you. And we have private lessons or semi-private lessons where you can set up and come in on a regular basis to learn how to knit or crochet.
It's really cool, and I had noticed that you guys are just right over here by the Habitat for Humanity here in Independence, and I drove by, I go, wow, the Yarn Mercantile. I was like, what is this place? And man, I come in, it is so bright and colorful. I mean, there's so many different selections that you have. Do you get it here locally, or do you get it from all over the country, or where do you get your surplus?
Our yarns are from U.S. distributors, okay. But they're manufactured all around the Europe. All around the world, Italy, okay. South America, Africa, even some China ones. Mm-hmm. So we have a wide range, not only in fiber content, but also in price. We okay. have some low end, some middle, and some really nice upper end.
Right. So it's kind of like the yarn industry, as far as knitting and stuff, it's kind of therapy, is it not?
Oh, yes. Yeah, so it's very therapeutic to knit. It kind of takes over your mind. And you kind of forget about other things that might be bothering you. So it's very therapeutic, absolutely.
I'm amazed on what you can make with obviously all different types of clothing. Now, when you're learning, someone that's just learning, that do you start off with something simple and then work your way up to making like a vest or a shawl or stuff like that?
Generally, we try to teach you something with the knit and purl stitch. Something simple might be a scarf. That's very popular as a first project. Mm-hmm. And if you're still interested after that, we'd start with a hat. But I have taught people that have jumped right in on their first project and did a full sweater.
Really?
Yeah.
So being in the industry, you can whip something out like that pretty quick.
No.
Now, notice that you do have some machines, too, that knitting machines. And how does that process work?
We have the Silver Reed line of knitting machines. They've been around for a long time. They started in the 50s.
Okay.
And machine knitting is different than hand knitting in that most people who machine knit because they are designing something, whether okay. just for their personal use or for somebody else. They love to design something, use the machine to produce it, and there they have this beautiful end product.
Okay.
It's a little less therapeutic, but it's wonderfully challenging.
Okay.
And I'll tell you, it just blows your mind with creativity with what you can do with them.
That's amazing. So where, again, are you located here in Independence?
We are located at 500 North Dodge and Avenue in Independence, which is one block west of Nolan and one block north of Truman, and basically right across the street from the Restore, if you know where Restore is.
Yeah, and not too far from the Independence Square, which is a great day, place to take a day trip or a road trip throughout the metro or beyond. Now, also, you have quite a bit of following on your Facebook. What Facebook pages do you have?
I have over 11,000 followers on Facebook, and that address is a.yarn.store.
Okay.
And Knit Craft started up their Facebook page last year, and it's Knit Craft Yarn, I believe. I don't have that one memorized.
Okay, no problem. And then how about a number where they can reach you and things like that for classes?
My number is 816-461-5505, and Knit Craft is 816-461-1249.
Okay.
You should have had me check that.
That's okay. No problem. But
you can call either number. Okay. And if you need to talk to Rita or Mary and you call in my line, I pass the phone over. That happens all the time. So 5505 is good.
But what I'd highly recommend is not just a call. You need to come down here and check this place out. It's awesome, guys. You'll be glad you did. Now, we do have a tagline on our radio show and our road show. And I just kind of threw it on before we came on here. But it's a Jed Clampett. Woo, doggies. Can you give me woo, doggies?
Woo, doggies.
You did good. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Darren.
Awesome. Hey, guys, you've been listening to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. Come on over here to Yarn Mercantile here in Independence. You'll be glad you did. And you've been listening to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. And we'll be right back. Hey, this is Darren with the Junk in My Trunk radio show. If you're looking for a great realtor, look no further. Michelle Moe with Remax Elite. Check her out online, michellemoe.com. Where do you want to be? Mo knows. 816-213-7000. I give her a big woo-doggies. Hey, welcome back to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. We're over here at Timeless Scrapbooking with Misty and Michelle. How you girls doing?
Fine.
Good.
Thank you for coming on the road show. Appreciate it. Can you tell the listeners and the viewers a little bit about your place, Misty?
Well, we have all your scrapbook needs. We have paper, scissors, stamps. We have kits. Pretty much everything you could ever ask for. Or need. We have the albums, stickers, stamps.
Just about anything for scrapbooking.
Yep. Anything and everything.
Awesome. Well, Michelle, how what do you think about the scrapbooking industry today?
I love it. I've only been doing it a couple of years, but I absolutely love it. And I have a lot of wonderful people that have helped me learn along the way. One of my business partner, Misty. But there's a lot of fun new stuff out there that people are doing in it. We love to see people bring in their albums and their books when they come in to show us, too, as well, what they're working on, because that's how we learn new things that are out there as well. But we have a ton of really, really cool stuff here that's can be used for basically any type of album, whether you're starting off as a beginner or whether you've been doing it for years.
That's awesome.
I mean, we have basically everything, and we have the experience in her, and then there's a beginner such as myself, which is great.
When I came by the other day, I noticed you were working on some windows, Misty, that you were working on. Is that a project that you do quite a bit of?
Yeah, we do. We do. We buy Restore windows, and we can do any kind of vinyl on them. The machine that I have does any kind of designs that you want. It can do lettering. It can do pretty much anything. We have some glass blocks that we're doing for some customers.
Okay.
And we can put designs on them. As a matter of fact, we're doing some logos for some apartment complexes.
Oh, very cool.
And then you put lights inside of them and they light up. I did one for my great niece that's due in about a month. So it's a nightlight for her baby room.
That is so cool. So how'd you come up with the name Timeless Scrapbooking?
We were looking for something that was catchy, but something that wasn't too long. We had about 10 different names, and we just kind of went through them and kind of checked off each one as we kind of went along, because you don't want something that's too long, and you want something that, you know, is kind of catchy, so.
Well, the thing is with timeless, I mean, everything that we do basically is timeless. Mm-hmm. And the really cool thing is, like, our logo also has a clock with no hands. So that's really neat because it is timeless. And we really, like I said, can preserve things that are old, new, you know, whatever you have. And that's part of it. And one of the logos on the window out there is making memories one page at a time.
Right.
And that's awesome. You know, we, one thing that I like to do is I frame just one page in a 12 by 12 frame. That's something that I like because it gives me a sense of completion. Versus working on a book. I mean, you can finish a book, but at the same, or an album, excuse me, but I like the fact that it's complete and done, and it's something different. And, you know, it's also a homemade, handmade gift for someone that really.
Absolutely.
What I'd also like about the area that you're in, you're in the downtown square here in Independence, Missouri.
Yes, and they're trying to revitalize it. They want new stores. They want to bring the square back to where it used to be.
Right.
And have, you know, more visitors and stuff like that. So
it's pretty amazing place. Where exactly are you located down here on the Independent Square?
We are at 220 West Maple Avenue. We're actually located at Maple and Osage. We're right on the corner.
Okay. Very easy to find.
Yes.
How about Facebook and things like that?
Yes, we have a Facebook page. It's Timeless Scrapbooking. And then we have a website, and it's www.scrappingonthesquare.com.
Scrappingonthesquare.com. I like that.
Yeah. Like that. We tried the Timeless Scrapbooking, but it was already taken by somebody else. And so her husband, our genius behind the computer, came up with that one. So
very good.
Yeah.
And speaking of my husband, he also did, we have a sign out there, and he's also made some of the fixtures here in the store. So that's really kind of nice, too, that he's able to do that. And he was actually the one that came up with the idea of finding the window panes. And the sign that is actually made, it's made from old pallets and refurbished things and stuff that we found, like, at the ReStore and stuff. So we really like that idea, too. And he loves doing it. And then he's also the tech genius behind the computer, because I'm not computer savvy, but she is. But
very good.
Hey,
well, we have a tagline on our radio show and our road show. It's a Jed Clampett, woo doggies. Can you give me woo doggies?
Woo doggies.
Awesome, you guys did so good. Again, guys, you want to come out and check out Timeless Scrapbooking down here on the Independent Square, you'll be glad you did. And you've been listening to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show, and we'll be right back.
Hey, this is Darren with the Junk in My Trunk radio show. Check out Morris Trash Hauling. Hauling of all kinds, 7 days a week, 816-252-8270. You can also check him out online at morrishauling.com. Free estimates, 7 days a week, total home cleanouts from A to Z. Handyman work available, power washing and staining. Again, senior citizen discounts available, 20 years experience, 816-252-8270.
We started at Hillcrest Thrift Store because we are all very fortunate. We have a lot, and we wanted to find some way to give back. So we first started working at the apartment, which our church has, St. Mark's. And from there, we learned about the thrift store. And so we started coming here and spending some time here.
I'm a volunteer coordinator here at Hillcrest. Every day I get to meet new volunteers that are as excited as I am about helping out the community and getting a sense of fulfillment. I also get to meet the residents living in our transitional housing apartments. It's a great sense of hope here. I just feel so grateful that I have all the essentials in my life. It's a great feeling knowing that you're really making a difference in someone's life.
My church is working with Uplift Organization. Their project for August was to collect t-shirts for people who are homeless and vets who are homeless. So they saved all the t-shirts they couldn't sell. They went overboard. I quit counting at 249. We were very surprised and thankful for Hillcrest's effort, because this took extra effort on their part. Thank you, Hillcrest.
Everybody has to give back what they have, and the good Lord's blessed me, and I want to be a blessing to somebody else, and that's what most people feel. I keep coming back basically because it's, number one, it's a lot of fun. There's a lot of good people here, and it's interesting. It's like Christmas every day. You open these boxes, you never know what you're gonna get.
As a volunteer, you get to experience something new every day. You get to find different treasures that come in donations, and everybody that comes in really enjoys it and has fun.
Sandy, have you read any self-help or motivation books lately?
Well, you know, Linda, I really don't need to read any self-motivation books, because when I come in here to Hillcrest, all I have to do is look up there on the wall. And there are all kinds of shirts up there that are great motivation for me.
You know what my favorite one is? He who laughs last thinks slowest.
My favorite one is, not now, I'm busy.
The camaraderie is terrific. So if you have some time, we'd love to have more people. And all you'd have to do is come and someone will show you what to do, and you get very great satisfaction.
We have a lot to do for our community, and we want you to join us. So come down to the Hillcrest Thrift Store and volunteer with us.
Hey, welcome back to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. We're over here at the Habitat for Humanity Restore and Independence with Michael Strawn, the director here. We're over at the Independence store, but they also have a Blue Springs location as well. Michael, could you tell the listeners and the viewers what they might find coming over to Habitat for Humanity?
Sure, Darren. Thanks for coming out today. The Habitat Restores are sort of like thrift stores, but they don't have the shoes and the clothes and the toys of other thrift stores. We kind of have the big boy stuff. We have windows and doors and toilets. We carry furniture, appliances, hardware, tools, all the cool stuff.
You really do have a lot of cool stuff, and what's really cool about it is it keeps on coming each and every week. It's usually if you want something, you better get it, because it will be gone.
It does. It comes in all the time. We have people that bring donations in every day, all day long, but we also have three trucks out on the road picking up donations for free. Okay. And that's one of the things that we're trying to get the word out right now, is it's easier to call us and have us come and get good donations than it is to put it out, take it to the landfill, put it in the dump, and we'll make good use of it.
And you guys are doing quite a bit of effort at the landfill and saving some stuff from going to the landfill.
We do. We actually have a truck at the Lee Summit landfill that goes down every day. And people who don't know about the restores, that think it's easier to take stuff into the dump, we catch things at the last moment, have them donate them. They get a donation receipt. We bring them back here, dust them off, and sell it, and turn those donations into cash for the local Habitat for Humanity affiliate.
Now, for someone that doesn't know about Habitat for Humanity, can you tell them how the program works?
Sure. It's Habitat for Humanity is a very large organization. It's a global organization, but it's made up of hundreds and hundreds of very small local organizations that we call affiliates. Truman Heritage Habitat for Humanity, which is our affiliate, serves families in eastern Jackson County, and our goal is to make safe, decent, affordable housing an option for any family willing and able to work for it.
Yeah, it's not like you just give something away free. These people actually are blood, sweat, and tears are being poured into it.
Absolutely. They have to put in 350 sweat equity hours. They do pay for the houses, but we provide a no-interest loan, and they don't have to qualify in the ways that you would through a conventional loan.
And then between the two stores, I live in Blue Springs, but I come over here as well. What would be the differences you might find between the two stores as far as merchandise goes?
The stores are defined by the local residents, and we have a lot of architectural salvage here in Independence, so we get some really cool older windows, doors, that sort of thing. But we also have a lot of hardware, just some of the smaller stuff, lumber and building materials. Mm-hmm. Now in Blue Springs, we have a good deal of furniture, appliances, and nice new windows, and some of the brighter, shinier stuff.
It's really cool. I like going over there. Actually, I was over there the other day, and I picked up a handful of readers. I need it to read. I have a hard time. but I picked up a few readers. And you also have specials that are going on when you come into stores, to be aware of things that have been there a little bit longer than others, and you have some really fantastic deals on some stuff.
We do. We set expectations for our customers. They know what to look for when they come in. When you come into either of our stores in Independence or Blue Springs, the first thing to check out is the window of opportunity. Okay. We've repurposed a window and we put up there what's on sale this week. Right. So our regular customers come in before they do anything, they say, "Where's that window?" And they find out what's going on.
Wow, that's awesome. How can one get a hold of you to donate to Habitat for Humanity?
Well, we have a couple of options. If you go to our website at trumanrestore.org, we have a page on there where you can fill out the information and we'll give you a call back and set up a donation time to come pick it up. Okay. Or you can call our store at 886-7374.
Awesome.
Okay. Yep.
Oh, yeah,
we'll
get that.
We'll get it. All right, good.
Yeah.
And then we'll set that time to come and get the donations.
That's awesome. Is there anything else you want to get out to the listeners and the viewers about Habitat?
Well, Habitat has a great reputation. And I've been here for about 4 years, and I kind of look every once in a while to see, you know, what are the dark spots here? And there just are none. Everybody that participates here, whether you volunteer, you donate, or you come in and go shopping with us, you benefit from what we're doing here. If you're a family that receives our services, you benefit from what's going on here. It's just, it's a good for everybody all around.
It really is. And I've talked to a few of the volunteers, and it's a really good time for them as well to give back into the community. And you guys have really done that, giving back to the community. We appreciate that too.
Well, we appreciate the support of all the community around us. It's not just us. I mean, we're 8 or 10 people, mm-hmm. but we're thousands of people because of the support that we get.
That's awesome. Well, we have a tagline on our radio show and our road show. I'm sure you're familiar with it. We've had Jed do it before, but it's a big woo doggies, like a Jed Clampett. We always ask our people to interview to give us a woo doggies.
Okay, we can try that. Right. Woo doggies.
That's awesome. Thank you so much for coming on, Michael.
All right. Thanks for coming out today. Appreciate
it. Hey, guys, you've been listening to the Junk in My Trunk Road Show. Check out Habitat for Humanity. You'll be glad you did. And we'll be right back.